Good morning, cultists. In our previous episode, we left things off after winning our invasion of Aquitaine, which unfortunately took a little bit longer than expected. Of course, that means that we now have a lot of vassal management to look forward to. So, sorry about that, unless you're into vassal management stuff as much as I am, in which case you're welcome, but most likely not the latter, I would say, for most of my audience. I don't know. In any case, we also might need to look out for some rebellions, but thankfully it's kind of small right now. Although, given enough time, I'm sure it's going to build up sometime soon, so yeah. I am currently 22 over my vassal limit. Now, I could reduce that by 5 by making the Duchy of Marrakesh, but let's see what we can accomplish by just whittling down the numbers here. So, the Duchy of Barcelona, I think that title will most likely just get destroyed. Although, let's see what we can do about this guy. Hold on. Can we, because we already also have Calatrava that's rebelling down here, so I'm gonna see what I can do to maybe, get these guys to disband and then re-raise somewhere else. Because the levies, we definitely don't want to disband right now. Because I'm over the vassal limit, that will unfortunately affect my, I think, maximum troop count. Sorry, trying to focus on this and do this at the same time. Alright. So this stack, go home. Fantastic. And you guys can try to do the same. Any knights in here? Nope. Doesn't seem like it. Fantastic, so that should be just my levy left, I believe. Great. Let's get you guys marching out to here and hopefully curb stomping them. But I guess you can just maybe converge there first. Or why don't we meet up here? That way we don't get waylaid and all that jazz. Alright, so Calatrava. I guess I'm a little worried that he might want to siege down my capital, but I think we might be alright? Question mark? Yeah, as long as he doesn't hire mercenaries, he shouldn't be able to siege down my capital. Alright, so troops, if you could please converge up over yonder. Fantastic. Let's just get you guys right in there. Great, go for it. I think that's fine as is. Alright, sure. Let's do this. So you guys will gather around. We might be able to whittle this down to the number of duchy titles, although that might take a bit of doing. What? Are you serious? I gave you land, yet you died on me. Was killed during a siege. Of what? 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 Peasant revolt siege? Are you kidding me? So where did it go? The peasant revolt. What is this nonsense? How dare you? Unbelievable. You are getting in the way of me doing some hefty vassal management, sir. Unbelievable. Fine. Zentulo? No, this guy's got really good prowess, which I would like to keep for myself. Ugh, really? Way to take the wind out of my sails there, buddy. I hate you. I hope you rot in hell. What a douche. Unbelievable. Let's go with this guy. His stats are garbage, but that's fine, because Tadla, I mean, I guess it has a couple of holdings, so maybe I could have been a bit more careful about that, but that's fine. And we have some rebellions building up, as I expected. Fair enough. So I guess we weren't able to capture this guy, right? Or was he never actually leading troops? Not entirely sure. Oh, a faction is disbanded? Okay. They're still building up a fair bit, though. I guess maybe we should go fight this guy. A scheme at court. My spymaster has come to me with grave news. While we do not know who, someone is plotting to kill me. To kill me? Me? What? How dare you? I ain't never done nothing to nobody. Unacceptable. Absolutely unacceptable. But can we please capture the Duke of Auvergne? Because if we do, then we can just end this war right here and now. Rather than have to faff about and chase these guys down and all that jazz. And we have captured Paul Vaughn. Vince Vaughn and Paul Rudd's illicit love child, of course. Okay, so... Oh! Whoa! Alright, so I guess these guys have enough power to stand against me. Sure. And we have various prisoners that we can ransom. Right. You know what? Let's just do this. And you, sir... where are you the ruler of? Oh, Scotland. Okay, then I guess there's no point in keeping you around. I was hoping that I could maybe squeeze some more money out of you, but I suppose not. Now, who's your heir? Never let his heir go. Or did I already ransom him? Have I ransomed you, sir? I have not. Gotcha. Okay. Yeah, captured heir. So, we'll ransom your other children, but not your heir. Sure. I guess he's only got 24 buckaronis left. And... 100%. Fantastic. This again? Wow. Alright, sure. Why not? Fuck you, sir. Fuck you. There you go. Fantastic. Alright, so he's got no money left, meaning that we can just take everything that he's got. Why can I not take this? Hello, sir. Can I take your County of Auvergne? I can. Fantastic. What about you? Not you. Let me just quickly give away the Duchy of Barcelona. I'm just gonna quickly check to see... make sure that the duchy is not ruled by... filthy heathens. Yep. Looks good. Alright, sir. Duchy of Barcelona is yours. Congratulations. Why? Why do you do this? Why do you marry people who are not of your wrong... Sure, she's never gonna believe in a religion, man! What is wrong with you? Unbelievable. Man, the AI is really dumb when it comes to marriages. I thought I was really bad about marriage stuff in this game, but it turns out that the AI is, like, much worse. Of course I say that, but I think I've already shown how terrible I am with that stuff. Oh, no, 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 no. We don't want to disband my, my peasants, just in case we actually need them. Alright, so I think the next target that we might want to work on is or Armagnac. So hopefully we can take this and then give away this duchy. Although, she does have a bit of money, so we might want to squeeze some more out of her. And what about the Duchy of Gascogne? Gascogne... Right, I think we have a couple of people that we need to revoke shit from. So, I guess we'll go with this guy then? Or do I want to deal with this first? Let's actually deal with this first. Yeah, so not disband all. I need to stop my mouse from hovering around that. I just want to mess with him, please. Alright, sir. It's time to let go of your county. And hopefully you'll just capitulate, even though the odds are fairly low? Nope. Looks like he's going to want to do a full-on Royal Rumble. Fair enough. Then I guess we will work on some of the counties here in the meantime. Yeah, he might rebel against me too, but that's fine if he does. He decided not to. Fantastic. Alright, miss, what about you? I'm assuming... Ah, you're no. Gotcha. Okay, filthy heretics. Get rid of them. Or heathens, I suppose. Sure. Alright, let me just quickly find someone for this new county. No, this guy's got amazing prowess. And sort by age, of course. Now, the reason why I'm sorting by age, in case you're curious, is because I don't really care about the stats of my vassals' vassals. Obviously, I care about the vassals themselves because I want to install, you know, pretty good dudes in there. But with vassals' vassals, it doesn't really make too much of a difference. Unless somehow the vassals' vassals end up becoming my vassals, I suppose. Sure. And the reason why I'm sorting by age is because I don't want them to die without any heirs. And if they're younger, then obviously they have a longer or better chance of getting children before they snuff it. So that way, the title just doesn't go back up to the to their liege, who is not me. I just keep clicking on the wrong shit. Is there a reason why she won't capitulate? She is terrified, so I'm assuming that she will want to at some point. Are you leading troops? You are. Okay, so you might want to actually just chase you down and maybe... Did you just hire mercenaries? Dude, what the fuck, man? Why? Why would you waste my money like that? I mean, why would you want to waste your money like that? What a douche. Unbelievable. I just stack wiped your mercenaries. You just wasted money on nothing. Congratulations, dumbass. Unbelievable. Absolutely unbelievable. Okay, I think we're going to need to go ahead and just revoke her shit anyways. Yeah, so this might... Oh, we are very undersupplied right now. I'm hoping that she doesn't bring in anyone else to the fight, though. Okay, so I think I'll actually ransom your ass and then squeeze out the 80 buckaronis. Yeah, sure. I mean, it does unfortunately slow things down a little bit, but that's fine. All right, so it's just her this time. Gotcha. Go siege him down. Although we're still over the supply limit. Once we get there, we'll be fine though. Or at least one stack will be fine. And she's of course leading troops, so go follow them through. And then the other stack can go siege that down, I suppose. All right, we don't have any onagers there, which is unfortunate, but that's fine. If you would like to raise your troops up against her, I would be more than willing to throw down with you again. Can we please capture her? Please? Ordonio, can you make sure that we capture this lady? So that we can just end this war immediately? And my level of splendor has increased. Fantastic. Very nice. And my wife has become an architect. Good for you, wife. Good for you. And you guys are taking quite a bit of time, so let me make sure that we have a proper siege leader in here. Thank you. We did not capture her, did we? You make me sad. You make me very sad, as a matter of fact. Let me just leave some dudes behind and then try to get some of our supplies back, I suppose. Alright, get in there. Oh, we need the other guys to go into our territory to be able to replenish supplies and all that jazz. Alright, so this is making some progress. Fantastic. And I'll be sure to put in a siege leader in here as well. To speed this up a little bit. I really wish that there was an option to just find a random siege leader type dude. Because, I don't know. But I also wish that there was like a siege leader... commander and a fighting commander, if that makes any sense, but I suppose, I don't know. Lacking literacy? My lord, it has come to my attention that you might require some tutelage in the art of deciphering written communication, my Grand Alama. Her... says, presenting me with a scroll. If it would please my lord, I would be willing to instruct you. I have the perfect text right here. Wait. Have I been illiterate this entire time? Wow. The king have had a big crown. Great. Yeah, I would like to become literate, please. Both in-game and in real life. Fantastic. The stress we don't need to worry about too much, thankfully. And that is done as well. Great. Sadly, unable to capture him again, but that's fine. All right. Thank you, and of course I shall be revoking your shit because I can. Congratulations. You are now landless. And same thing with your Muwalati dudes. Alright, sir. You... There you go. Fantastic. Okay, so let me just quickly find someone for this county and then we will be on our way. There's gotta be a better way of doing this, I would imagine. Damn it. I don't want to install people who are too good for my vassals. Or, yeah. There we go. I think this guy's fine. Alright, so that should be the entire Duchy of Toledo good to go, I think. Once we make this title and give it away, That should lower our count by another 5, so that'll put us at 12. Do I want to do that though? Because we're actually about to give away Gascogne, which will lower our vassal count by 4. In the meantime, I think we'll also work on you. Yeah, she will most definitely rebel against me, but that's fine. And I will, of course, make sure that we have our siege leaders or our onagers move up to here. Fantastic. And just move in there. Great. All right, little girl. I guess you don't have any friends to help you out with this war, so fine by me. If crushing is what you require, then crushing is what you'll get. Eat shit, little girl. Eat shit. Consume the feces. Fantastic. Sadly, unable to capture her, but that's fine. Great, so I could potentially ransom you for your 49 ducats and then do that again. Or is that not really what we want? I'm gonna see something here, but because I've noticed that at times I can actually ransom people, landless people, for 100 ducats. So I'm gonna see if that's possible now. Nope, not with her apparently. Okay, I guess I made a mistake. Oops. Alright, Dax and this county too. Or that holding, rather. Alright, there we go. So who wants this last county of Gascogne? Let's go with this guy. Nope, he's got a family. I could just look for the lowborn dudes. Oh, there we go. I think this guy's fine. He's not spectacular at anything in particular. And before I give away the duchy, I'm just going to make sure that we have all Almohadi dudes. Perfect. And of course, the dude in Bordeaux is going to be the Duke of Gascogne. Perfect. Very nice. So, I am now only 13 over my vassal limit, if you can believe that. But I think we might want to prioritize their capital first, in terms of a siege order. So, let me just leave the onagers behind, and then you guys can go help out with that siege, I suppose. Sure. And of course, siege leader. Fantastic. We'll deposit some men-at-arms and then bugger off. You know what? Just leave those dudes behind and then just get back into our territory. Yeah, same thing with these guys, I guess. Just to avoid any supply limit issues. There we go. Okay, so while that's happening, Auvergne, what about you, sir? 67% chance that he might just capitulate. I think we should take that opportunity. Unless there's something else that we should do? I don't think so. Calatrava. I think with Calatrava, because he's so close to my territory, I'll just ransom him and then just squeeze out the rest of his money. Alright, sir. Then I'm gonna do you. Once I get that duchy, though, Auvergne is thankfully only 4 counties. Okay, so this guy's territory we can just take. He, I believe, has 1 county to himself. Belay, right? So we will need to eventually revoke a couple more counties then. Then maybe we should wait. I mean, I guess we can get started now, but just in the off chance that he wants to get fresh with me, might not be the worst idea to wait. But we'll head in that direction, I guess. Now, we are spending a lot of money on maintaining my troops and all that jazz, but I'm a little scared to let go of them just yet. Yeah. Oh, what happened to our siege leader? Right. I keep forgetting that that happens. Alright, that's fine. Even though this siege is pretty much done. You might as well just, you know. Alright, siege leader here as well. Just in case, I'm fairly certain we might not need it. Considering that she's not able to lead troops. So, assuming that we can capture her. We did not capture her. You make me very sad. I could have ransomed her for like 100 ducats. What is this garbage? 10 ducats? What do I look like? Some kind of person who'd be satisfied with 10 ducats? Unbelievable. Absolutely unbelievable. Alright, since we're here, let's just do this. Let's throw down, good sir. Alright, Buckaroo. Oh, he just capitulated. Fine by me. Then what about you, sir? He might accept. Okay. I guess we'll get started on that now. And of course I can't do this because... Son of a bitch. It sucks that you can't send out multiple requests. You've got to be kidding me. So... Oh, you know what? That's perfect because it's the two counties that we do need. Fantastic. Well, kind of. Would have been better if it hadn't worked out that way, but still. Alright, so we'll revoke that. Thank you. Now, I do wonder if it's possible for me to, send out a request to get them to convert. Hope that they say no or give me a reason to, imprison them and then just maybe fuck around with them or something. This guy's really old. And then, maybe rip them off that way. I mean, I suppose it's possible in theory, but I don't know how willing the barony tier vassals are to accepting your request to convert. I'm fairly certain, because they're usually really weak, that they're most likely going to just capitulate and give in to your demands, or acquiesce to your demands, which of course means that we can't just revoke their or have an excuse to imprison them and all that jazz. But yeah. Okay, so that's this place done. Finally. Good grief. Okay, you have a bit of money though, so I'm going to go ahead and try to squeeze that out of you. Of course, this means that we'll have to do this again, but that's fine. Because we are currently working on some other stuff at the moment, so... I don't mind us being a little distracted, I suppose. Alright, so wait. Oh, wait. Shouldn't I have another... two siege leader type dudes? Yeah. What about the other guy? Tell me that he's in here somewhere. There we go. Ugly man. I mean, Handsome McGee. And of course he rebelled against me again, which is fair enough. Can we actually capture her this time? Hey, we got profit. Fantastic. Okay, so we can now actively think about how we should reform our faith. So, I don't think we'll end up reforming our faith today, but here's what I'm thinking in terms of doctrines. I'm still not 100% sure on tenets because, I'm not gonna lie, none of them really speak out to me besides warmonger, which we have to give up. But legitimization, and of course, our religion will be all about the partying and recruitment, either, and temporal revocable. I'm actually thinking, what if we turn this around on and then just mess around with the whole thing and go with a female dominated? What if we do that? I think though it's probably better if we just go with equal and then eventually install a female ruler when we can. Yeah. So obviously we don't have the piety for it, but one Hajj should be enough to get us what we need. And in terms of warmonger, we'll keep struggle and submission, because I think that's one of our central doctrines as a Muslim religion. Although I've noticed that some Muslim faiths don't have that either. So for instead of warmonger, I was thinking maybe we can do... Fatwa? I don't know. I mean, like I said, none of them really speak to me. Maybe unrelenting faith. Because as much as I like the rap battles that we can do with literalism, at a certain point, 250 piety is going to be chump change. And I don't think it's going to be super useful. Except for the whole, you know, these things being a virtue or whatever. But even still. So instead of warmonger, I was thinking fatwa, and instead of literalism, maybe not pursuit of power because I don't really like ambitious. Unrelenting faith? Okay, so we definitely need about maybe 4,000-ish piety to be safe. Now, I know what you're thinking. Why don't I go with carnal exaltation and, like, polyamory and, all the sex-related stuff? I mean, certainly yes, but not for this campaign. I think for a future campaign, we might want to go with the, divine marriage and, polyamory and, all that lovemaking stuff. Yeah, the, carnal exaltation. So... Yeah, I don't know. I mean, none of them really speak out to me. So, I was thinking this, but this is kind of boring though, isn't it? I don't know. I don't know. I think for now though, maybe this is kind of what we'll aim for, but we can always change it out later on. I mean, obviously, once we commit to an idea, we can't really change it, but you know what I mean, right? Or maybe you don't. Oh, you've increased the control in Cordoba. Fantastic. Let's have you increase the control in, I guess here next, sure. And my acquaintance Andre has died. All right, well, Andre the not-so-giant has apparently snuffed it. Fair enough. And this is taking a little while to siege down. Sweet Lady Aldonza, I sigh as I kneel before her. My only desire is to bring you honor and happiness. Pray tell me, how can I prove my love to you? She hesitates and her cheeks turn red. By Allah, I hope she's pleased and not embarrassed. Slay a wolf for me and bring me its pelt, then we may continue this conversation. Okay, so, wow, my prowess is not that bad. How come my prowess challenges are terrible? 61% chance? Or, you know what, I'm just gonna bribe the hunter instead. Yeah, thanks, cause it seems that I have no real chance to, well, I mean, kind of, but not really a chance to make it on my own. If I were to ransom you, 10 buckaronis, that's it? Wow. Thanks for the chum change. Good grief. Fine, we'll just siege that down the old-fashioned way. I was really hoping that we could actually do this, get this done in this episode, but it seems that it might take a little bit longer, which is kind of a shame. Maybe I should just, I don't know, try to get through this as quickly as possible. Now, one thing that would help us out is if these guys all just rebelled at the same time. Of course, that carries the innate danger of them actually overpowering me, which I don't think will actually happen, but are you fucking kidding me? We failed to imprison this child again? You're joking. Wow. That is infuriating. How did this war end before the other one? Unbelievable. And I was not able to capture any of your family members. You guys make me sad, you know that? You guys make me really sad. Well, try to capture the other guy's family too, if we can. Or maybe the other guy himself, because that would be fantastic if we can manage that. But that's gonna take another 3 months? No way. You're kidding, right? Another 3 months. Wow. Why is that taking so long? Good grief. And this place will be 58 days. I mean, can't you just make some, like, I don't know, giant wooden badgers or bunnies or something? And then have some troops waiting inside? Like a Trojan badger or... What is happening here? Why do we have 13 dudes just on a boat? Starving? What are you doing? Were you trying to, like, I don't know, like, film, your own Basque version of the hit movie Castaway or something? I don't understand. That was so bizarre. And this will be done in 13 days. Okay, so I'll just revoke your shit in between episodes. And what about you, miss? You know what? I'm actually gonna revoke your shit right now. Can I just revoke? I don't want the duchy right now, though. But fine, whatever. Okay, so no other holding here, and that's not the capital of that duchy, so let me just quickly find someone for this place. Yeah, sure, let's go with this guy. Why not? Fantastic. And miss? Please tell me that you just capitulate? No, you won't. Okay, fine. I guess I'll just wreck your shit too, then. Unbelievable. Alright, so that's gonna take 4 months, and we have not managed to capture either of them. Unbelievable. Can I ransom your family members? I have none of your family members, do I? What about you, sir? You've got 49 ducats? That's it? Okay, well, that's the Duchy of Auvergne basically done and dusted then. Yeah. Let's see, so I could potentially squeeze out a bit more money from these dudes. I don't know if it's really worth it, though. You know what, maybe with this guy at least. Yeah, you know what, we'll ransom you. And you have 49 ducats. I'm gonna ransom you as well. And then we'll just siege them back down again. Sure. I apologize if this isn't really your jam, but I'm just trying to set myself up for not disaster, as it were. As in, I don't want to be left with no money or resources with which to develop my shit, so I figure that this wouldn't be a bad idea to acquire said resources. Alright. Let's do this again. Thankfully, they're now separate wars, so they can't piggyback each other, off each other, rather. And you've actually had a son. Interesting. Not that it really matters, mind you, but still. What is this peasant revolt for? Okay, is that going to be a problem? Possibly. Again with this? Yeah, sure, make him my rival, why not? Fuck you, sir. Fuck you. And, yeah, I think we might definitely want to get more onagers, seeing how slow this is, for sure. Alright, otherwise, can we actually maybe capture some of these guys? Are you leading troops? You are indeed. Alright, sir. Hold on, I'm just gonna come and pummel your butthole. Visions of the Divine. I beckon my vassal, Grand Alama, to join me in the circle of brass orbs and candles arranged on staffs throughout the dark room. The incense cloying the air to ward off the bad vapors makes our eyes chirp in little time. This is how, through the corner of my eyes, we will spot the inscrutable form of angels. And of course, he's not happy about this. But yeah, okay, fine. I'll go with that option, I guess. So far, I've taken a lot of options that may lead down a path of zealousness, but has done nothing yet. Which I guess isn't necessarily a bad thing, but still. And you also have a bit of money. Damn it! Can you guys not have money, please? Or should I just revoke their shit? I don't really want to have to do this again twice. You know what? Fuck you. There you go. Can I ransom you for 100 buckaronis? Yeah, see? That's so weird. I wonder what that stipulation is. I wonder why that happens. What determines whether or not I can squeeze them out for 100 buckaronis or 10? Doesn't seem to be much in the ways of consistency in that regard. But maybe I'm just not really noticing. Which is entirely possible and quite likely, as a matter of fact. Alright, not that guy. This guy's prowess is actually fairly good despite being club-footed. There we go. Right, Bern is yours. Congratulations. Alright, so Duchy of Armagnac. Or however you're supposed to pronounce that. I'm pretty sure I'm just butchering the pronunciation. So much so that I can't even say the word butchering. Apparently I say butchering. I don't know what that means. But I guess it's appropriate. Alright, so that's that duchy done. And I'm going to see what I can do about you guys. Sure. Although we can just lower and re-raise these dudes somewhere else. Yeah, let's just teleport them instead. So we'll start here. Sure. And then go for the rest. Oh, and I have just encountered the Peasant Rebellion. Which is fine by me, because, I mean, we might need to deal with them anyway, so sure, why not? Alright, go chase them down. Oh, no, they disbanded troops? Are you kidding me? In hostile territory too, no less. Wow. Alright, well, you're done and dusted, good sir. Okay. Send those guys there, and now you don't have any money left, so I guess it's fine. This guy, he's only got like 85 buckaronis. You know what, just fuck him. We'll just take everything that he's got. Why don't you guys try to maybe worry about your supply a little bit more. Alright, leave some dudes behind, and then move on to the next county. Fantastic. So, I'm going to try to do as much as I can in this episode before we end the episode in terms of vassal management stuff. Can I revoke your kingdom title, sir? Obviously, he's going to rebel against me, which is fine by me. Let's deal with Auvergne first. So, we'll give away this duchy, and then I think we can maybe work on Yeah, let's work on their duchy titles. If they're all county level dudes, then we can just siege their shit down and we should be fine. Yes. Apparently my love for a lady, or if my wife has caused another invasion or intrusion? So it turns out it's my love for my wives that's causing their assassination attempts. And you know what? I think I might actually make her my soulmate, considering that she is the mother of Ricardo, who is currently focusing on a diplomacy education. I think I might want to go with a stewardship focus, though. Yeah, at least for our next generation. I'm gonna not have that option on yet, though. Although, learning then? I mean, his learning's not bad. Right now, his stewardship is his lowest score, surprisingly enough. All right, I'll make you my soulmate. Sure, why not? Fantastic. So, besides her loving me more, does this have any other benefit? Not entirely sure. All right, sir. You are done and dusted as well. Congratulations. Yeah, I'm just gonna revoke your shit. And maybe I'll get lucky and be able to ransom me for the rest of your money. Maybe not. I honestly have no idea. It's so inconsistent, I feel. But I could be wrong, of course. Alright, and of course, Auvergne itself. From this dude. Sure. Okay. I really wish that there was an easier way to look at my direct vassals who are of the wrong religion, but sadly there isn't a way, which is kind of dumb. I don't understand the decision behind that, but sure. Okay, so Auvergne, that's the capital there. Fair enough. Do we want a nope? Maybe a marshal type dude or a stewardship type dude? We're okay in terms of, I would say, just about everything. Couple of vassals who are only 40 years old, so I don't think we need to worry about them. This guy eventually might need to be replaced. This guy more so. So maybe we want to go for a learning type dude? Ah, evil atheist. Do we want an evil atheist to be my court chaplain? Or do we want this guy, who is a content gambler, to be my court chaplain instead? I think maybe having a court chaplain who is cynical might not be the best idea in the world. So I'm thinking maybe we'll go with this guy. Yeah. Your stats are not too bad and you're 47 years old. Now this guy's much younger. Tempting. Or this guy. Would actually kind of be the best of both worlds. Alright, what about sorting by prowess? 21 prowess, not bad. 20. Okay. Well, then what about sum of all skills? Arcason. I see. This guy's shown up a couple of times. He might be the one to take Auvergne. Actually, wait. Auvergne is 4 counties, right? Let me try to find someone who's got pretty high marshal. No, you know what? We'll just go with the sum of all skills. All right, let's go with this guy. 0 diplomacy, but that's fine. Auvergne is yours. Congratulations. Oh, wait, nope. That's the barony itself, not the capital. I think that should be fine. That's a virtue. Yeah, you know what? Fuck it. I don't want to have to think about that too much. Because otherwise I'll just go down a rabbit hole, believe you me. Which I'm sure you've already noticed. Maybe I shouldn't worry too much about the dudes having really high prowess and all that jazz. Because we already have really good knights and all that stuff, so I suppose it's a bit of a moot point, isn't it? Alright, sure. Then I'm going to give you the county of this place. Followed by who else? You. Perfect. Enjoy. Fantastic. And the Duchy of Auvergne obviously goes to you, good sir. There we go. Oh, Almost clicked on that again. And this is gonna pop off in 32 months. Fine by me. All right, so let's see. Okay, we're going to have to make that title then. See, the opinion map mode would actually be make this process a lot easier, because then I can see exactly which ones are higher rank, etc., etc. If that makes any sense. Although I guess it's time to work on the kingdom itself. So how about I do this? And he's got no money left, so there's actually no point in doing the whole thing where we ransom him again and again. And if we can maybe capture him, though he doesn't seem to be leading troops, I guess it doesn't really matter. Dang it. Okay, try to siege down his capital, I guess, and then maybe if we can capture him and his children, then we should be good. Easier said than done, of course. And in the meantime, I guess we'll also work on you, sir. Yeah, just because we can. Sure. Alright, go kick his teeth in. Although, oh shoot, I should have actually started inside of the capital. That's fine. This might take a bit of doing, so it's, oh, nope. Wrong stack, guys. Wrong stack. And apparently I had a hook on Catalina? I didn't realize that I had a hook on my doctor. Sure. Oh, my spy master has come to me with a discovery. She's certain that my courtier Isra is scheming against me. Ah, interesting. That would make sense. All right, so we can throw her in jail. Let the traitor be known to all. Or, you know what? Throw her in jail. Fuck you. How dare you, miss? Unbelievable. I let you go under questionable reasons, and this is how you repay me? Unacceptable. All right, let's send 3,000. Oh, I guess we can. Then maybe just stay. Nope, nope, that's not it either. You know what? Just go there. Sure. Just to avoid the loss of supplies and all that jazz. Okay, so if we can capture the king and his family. Did you change clothes? Did you? There wasn't a succession, was there? Oh. Oh, now you're allied to France? Wow. Okay, we were not able to capture him himself, which is unfortunate, but, sure. Why don't you guys... Nope, wrong stack. Go attack those dudes. And why don't you get in a little bit closer just in case France actually wants to help out his son. And of course, let's not forget to put in those siege leaders. Man, there's got to be an easier way to do this. I swear. I feel like just add a button to find the next best siege leader. You know, next best dude with the military engineer trait who's got the highest martial score or whatever. I feel like that would be a good way to do it, but I don't know. Maybe I'm wrong. I usually am, so, you know, there's that. If France is leading troops himself, it might be worth actually attacking their stack. Because then maybe we can capture him and then ransom him for more money. And also, it would get rid of the axe that's kind of like hanging over my head, in a way, I suppose you could say. And of course, he is now buggering off, because he's a big, big bitch, isn't he? Alright, fine. We'll go chase you down then, Mr. Big Bitch. And my wife has snuffed it. Well, that's unfortunate. Okay. Let me go find a new wife. Who is... preferably infertile? There we go. Do I want to marry you? No, I'm gonna marry you. Rahat. Sure. Not matrilineally, obviously. There we go. Okay. Well, that's not really an issue though, is it? Who's my next best stewardship wife? I guess you can be my primary spouse for now. And that should hopefully... Yep, it fixed it. Fantastic. And we're about to hit those dudes up. Great. Still only 89% war score? Are you kidding me? Dude, I've sieged down everything you have. Well, not everything. But, you know, close enough. Just give up. Just give it up, bub. Actually, why don't we go support them just in case? Because we're not starting things off on a great note. Sure. Now, these guys should be fine by themselves. And, of course, we're kicking his teeth in. Are you joking? Still only 98%. How is that even possible? What the fuck? Come on, man. I'm trying to run a legitimate business here. What is this garbage you keep feeding me? Unbelievable. And we're not even getting a ticking war score either. Oh, son of a bitch. Now he's in Sevilla. What the fuck? Okay, maybe we can capture his children or something. Although, unlikely. So we might need to... Do I want to hire mercenaries to deal with this nonsense? Okay, apparently I lost a spy master. Alright, wife, you can be my new spy master. And am I married yet? I should be, right? Yes, I am. Alright, miss, please convert, and then we'll have you be my new primary wife, I suppose. I still have a pretty high maximum. I don't know if that's going to change if I lower some of my levy, though. I should check to see. Alright, be my new primary spouse. Thank you. And that will not change my domain holding limit, it turns out. Fantastic. Okay, so we captured one of them. Or his wife, rather. That was it? Unbelievable. Alright, so I can disband you guys. And then re-raise you next to Sevilla. Let me... get these pikemen the fuck out of here. And the same with these dudes. Sure. And then you guys can just go home. Yeah, we have 80 levy. I'm gonna see if that actually changes my maximum. 8717. 8687. Yeah, that definitely changed my maximum. Gotcha, so it shouldn't be lowering retinue, is it? What the fuck? Oh, right, right, because they're still allied. Of course. So you... Did you hire mercenaries? Of course you fucking did. Because you're a loser. That's why. That's not a lot of troops. But sure, maybe we can actually acquire enough to be able to fight them back. Which is doubtful. But we still have to try, I suppose. Go home. And we have a stack of French dudes coming in, so we might want to skedaddle the fuck out of there, just in case. Just in the off chance that they're actually able to get fresh with me, as it were. Alright, so if I were to fight these guys with that stack, we would actually do pretty well. You know what? Why don't we spend a bit more time to gather some troops and then start making our way? Go for it. And we'll get that organizer in there. Oh, nope, that's not the organizer. There we go. Alright, so once you guys are close, or at least able to get right in there, let me switch you out, and... Well, should be fine either way, I think. Okay, so this is... Yeah, that's what I thought. This one might be a little touching... Oh, we're actually winning! Surprisingly enough. And of course, you've actually been able to siege that down, which is fine by me. 89%. Maybe that victory with France will be enough to... Nope, it was not enough to do anything, as it turns out. Great, thanks. Really, really appreciate it. Unbelievable. Okay, so that's them defeated. And can we actually push back against Scotland? Yeah... Probably not, considering how powerful they are in that that stack there. Okay. I think for now, though, we might want to just leave our dudes in Sevilla. Just try to siege that down. That should be the last bit of a war score that we need, hopefully. And then... Okay. Apparently that's happening now. But that's fun. Alright, well, thankfully it's only one county, it seems, which is really strange. Not gonna lie. Didn't think that they would just, do that, but sure. Also, siege leader. There you go. Can we go try to fight their troops again? Are you leading troops? Nope, you're down there. Okay. Can we maybe chase them down? Fuck off. Where are they retreating to? I kind of wish I could see exactly where they're going to. I'm assuming they're just going to here, because maybe they're just trying to get away as far as humanly possible, I suppose. Still only 87%. Or 77% with this stack. And only 85 with... How the fuck is this still only 85%? That makes no sense. There we fucking go. My god, that took so long. Good grief, I'm so sorry. This is going on for, like, ages. I'm trying to, like, keep this contained to, like, one episode or whatever, but, it might not be really viable. Lead to gold. The transmutation of lead to gold has been long the dream of alchemists across the world. Though many have attempted such a feat, nobody is known to have succeeded. Despite this, I've come across some notes written in the margins of a book about plants. They claim that one can create golden rain by boiling lead sugar in a filtered solution of seaweed ash. Could such a thing be possible? Do I want to? I can actually gain a learning lifestyle perk. Logical thinking for 5 years. Or just gain some piety. You know what? Nothing ventured, nothing gained. If nothing else, then maybe we'll end up with the world's finest green, but that's okay. We can sell it to a Percy at a incredibly crazy price. Just to rip him off a little bit. And hopefully this will be the last fight that we need to do with this guy. The first reagent I need to obtain is sugar, an ingredient used to sweeten wines. Okay, I guess maybe that was the primary use of sugar back in the day. I could find a supplier to import what I need, though it would be expensive. Alternatively, I can cheaply manufacture my own by burning metallic lead and dissolving the ashes in vinegar. I'm sorry, what? Burning metallic lead and dissolving the ashes in vinegar. Oh, right, because they actually used to use lead to, like, sweeten stuff back in the day. Oh, yeah, and that led to a lot of our problems, obviously. Okay. So, I can have a chronic headache for 20 years, or gain 100 learning lifestyle experience. I guess either way, I increase by learning by one? I don't really want to have chronic headaches for 25 years. That's a... moderate health penalty. Or sorry, 20 years rather. And there's no percentage for either. Well, as much as I want to learn, increase my learning by one permanently, I think I'll actually not take the chance, thanks. Sure, I'll just use the money that I don't have. Fantastic. And he has been captured. Fan-fucking-tastic. My goodness. Okay. So, I think now would actually be a good time to end the episode. What is happening with you? Peasant rebels. Okay, we're going to need to help you out here, aren't we? Definitely. And you too, Toulouse. Because you apparently are having some issues as well. Alright, so... Oh no, it seems that Toulouse might need some help desperately, as it turns out. Okay, where are my... men-at-arms? Have they not been raised? Oh, nope, they've been raised. They're somewhere. There we go. Oh, there they are. Right, because they had that royal rumble with that dude just now. Gotcha. Alright, go kick their teeth in, and then we'll help them defeat that. So, yeah, let's end the episode off here for now. I apologize that we weren't able to completely... finish our vassal management stuff in this one episode, but I guess maybe me taking my sweet-ass time trying to revoke shit and milk them for all the money that they have might have contributed to that slowness, for which I apologize. So there might be another half episode remaining about vassal management stuff, but I don't think it'll go on for the full hour, which I prefer not to do, but oh well. So, I'll be sure to revoke the counties, or the titles from the dudes. actually, I might leave some of them. Yeah, the guys who don't have a lot of money will definitely revoke shit from, like this guy, for example. But the rich ones, we might want to leave and repeatedly basically cyberbully until we've ripped them off of all of their buckaronis. What? Are you serious? I give you land, and you just go and die to syphilis. Unbelievable. What a douchebag. Alright, well that's fine. More land for someone else, I guess. But yeah, I think that kind of makes sense. So again, I apologize, but, you know, I'm just trying to, like, make sure I don't go broke and all that jazz, so... Hopefully this works out and isn't a giant waste of my time, and your time too. And we're actually, close to being within our vassal limit too. And I haven't really lost much money since we started this whole vassal, management process, I suppose. Alright, so for now, thanks for watching and have a good breakfast!